Before we could get this application to work, we had to make a few tweaks. First, in traffic config for Zulip, the only whitelisted subnet was the one from WireGuard, because our application would try to connect to Zulip from inside a Docker container, we had to whitelist all Docker subnets. Second, we had to fix IP tables. Connecting from outside the VPS worked. Packets hit the pre-routing chain in net table, and by following all the rules, they end up in a traffic container. Same thing is true for packets originating from the VPS itself, except the packets would first hit the output chain. However, if the packet is coming from inside one of the Docker containers, it would again hit the pre-routing chain, but then in Docker chain it would hit a return rule, because the interface this time is a Docker bridge interface. Since there were no more rules, packet goes to the filter table input chain, and there it gets dropped because of the chain policy. We had to add rules that would specifically allow packets coming from the Docker subnets with the destination ports 80 or 443. That way, those packets would also end up in a traffic container, which would then route them to the appropriate service. Third, we had to allow connections to MariaDB server for backup script user from those same Docker subnets. We've then created a new stream in Zulip, VPS, we've added a generic bot, do-bot, and we've created a expected backups file with a list we'll use for comparison with the state in MariaDB. With the help of the Docker file, we've created a Docker image. In GitLab, we've created a new project, added project variables, and with those in place, we've added gitlabci.yml. This time, pipeline had four stages. First one builds two Docker images, one with pipeline ID and commit hash as tag, and one with tag latest. Second stage pushes those images to the private container registry in GitLab. We used predefined variables for tagging the image and for authenticating to the registry. Third stage sets up the variables, some of them as literal strings and some of them by reading the project variables we've set up in GitLab project. With all variables ready in .env file, we run the application using the Docker image with the latest tag. And finally, in fourth stage, we remove Docker images that GitLab runner has built on the VPS. Otherwise, those would pile up over time and you would have those images both on the server and in the private container registry. I've then showed you how you can download images from the private registry on another machine. You again first authenticate, then run Docker pull with the tag you want to download, and then you can run the container locally. But make sure that wherever you are running the container, your application can reach the necessary services, in this case MariaDB and Zulip. And finally, in GitLab, we've set up a CI/CD schedule so that we get this backup report each morning without the need to push new files to the repository to trigger the job.